Restored Republic via GCR update as of April 8, 2020. Patience is a virtue. Having virtue is a sign of a good moral being. Good moral beings have the power to overcome evil and change the world. Divide they try, fail they will, where we go one we go all. To support POTUS, follow Q and trust plan. Extraordinary times, it turns out, do not always call for extraordinary measures, or even extraordinary people. They often call for ordinary measures and ordinary people finding ways to do ordinary things when everything around them seems to make ordinariness impossible. Michael Austin, by Common Consent blog post. Judy note, Fleming's military contact reported that Tier 4B internet group's start time was dependent on present military operations to rescue children, arrest perpetrators and when they could assure that safety issues were in place. President Trump wanted funds for the internet group to be released between now and Friday the 10th of April, or it could extend into next week. Bruce and Marks both predicted we would obtain appointments between now and Wednesday the 15th of April. On Sunday the 5th of April, President Trump said it was going to be a rough week and a half, but that there is light at the end of the tunnel, things going well, which paralleled a FBI contact info that Trump wanted it started for us between now and Friday the 10th of April. They want to be done by Friday, but it might go into next week. Fleming, Trump's priority was still to get it done this week, including starting T4B, though as an FBI contact said yesterday, it might go into Monday the 13th of April. A Treasury contact said that releasing funds for all tiers was the way the stimulus bill payments were being paid for this week into next. Priority transactions were to start Tuesday the 7th of April after 3:30 p.m. EDT. On where the 8th of April private transactions were to start. Tiers 3,4A and Tier 4B would be started any time between now and Monday the 13th of April. Markets, I'm not really looking for much to come out until this next long Easter weekend. I am hearing this from all my banking contacts and paymasters are looking for something to happen over this Easter weekend, to be in place by Tuesday the 14th of April. My folks working at redemption centers dealing with the exchange logistics also say they won't be ready until then. The Saint Germain Trust opens up on Easter Sunday. That would be a perfect time to launch this thing. On the 1st of April they said the stimulus checks were coming in 2 weeks, making it Tuesday the 14th of April. Bruce, we finished the 3 days of darkness Sunday night the 6th of April. CMKX package delivery would begin Wednesday the 8th of April. President Trump wanted us to start sometime between now and Good Friday the 10th of April. Something big was supposed to happen Easter Sunday the 12th of April. The Saint Germain Trust should be opened around Easter. We were in a window to be paid Wednesday the 8th of April through Wednesday the 15th of April. Stimulus monies and our appointments were coming by Wednesday the 15th of April. A bank source said 2-3 days after Easter, that we'll kick it out to Wednesday the 15th of April. A must-watch video, you may want to watch it twice, the storm is here, children are being saved, coronavirus update, www.youtube.com/weblink. 2:45 explanation of the situation that we have now. 407 Chinese scientist named Li Chen defected to the US carrying diskette record of China's most dangerous new biological weapon. They call stuff Wuhan 400 because it was developed at their DNA labs outside of the city of Wuhan, and it was 400th viable strain of man-made microorganism created at that research center. Wuhan 400 is a perfect weapon. It afflicts only human beings and also called the zombie virus. 351 Sura's owned biotech Wuzi Pharma Tech Incorporated Wuhan, 666 Goxin Road East Lake. 1951 selling human adrenochrome Alibaba.com. 2216 the marker of adrenochrome's junkers adrenochrome selling, www.sigmildrich.com weblink. 2017 John Jr. Kennedy aka Vincent Fushka, please pray for the mole children, returning to the light with unspeakable trauma. Plus 25 hours 27 minutes. 2142 rescue children in hospitals plus 27 hours 33 minutes plus 27 hours 45 minutes 5 million children enslaved. 28 hours 20 minutes ships jails. 1822 corona, wait for a photo to appear. B. April 7, 2020 Fleming from military intel contact. 1. Trump's priority was still to get it done this week, including starting T4B, though as an FBI contact said yesterday, it might go into Monday the 13th of April. 2. Yesterday a Treasury contact said that releasing funds for all tiers was the way the stimulus bill payments were being paid for this week into next. 3. Priority transactions were to start today Tuesday the 7th of April after 3:30 p.m. EDT. 4. On where the 8th of April private transactions were to start. 5. Tiers 3,4A and Tier 4B would be started any time between now and Monday the 13th of April. The claim that T4B was not starting till May 1st or November 2020 was pure disinfo, unfounded speculation. 6. Current military operation against deep state leaders, cartels and human trafficking networks must be largely completed before T4B was started, as the elders were insisting on it and the Department of Defense and Trump were working on it with them. 7. Contact Daniel D., who was working with the SBA loan processor, said that PP deliveries were scheduled to go out tomorrow where the 8th of April into Thursday the 9th of April. 8. Department of Defense, anywhere between Thursday the 9th of April and Easter Monday the 13th of April these events would start to occur. 9. The 3 days of Dunkis this week would not take down the internet. It would just continue regional rolling phone network outages and regional rolling internet outages, as has happened over the past several days as military, reserve, and special operation troops continued arresting deep state rats and bringing down the deep state cartels that were trafficking drugs, guns, cash, children, women, etc., and as military units removed deep state threats, dark nodes, contaminated COVID-19 test kits, potential use of facial recognition software, 5G tower control from deep state operators, etc. All this was happening now. 10. Global mass arrests to take down deep state control were happening right now behind the scenes without publicly visible martial law, though there was martial law behind the scenes in the US. Martial law was also public in some other countries right now. 11. Like it or not, RRV, GCR start was not being done in isolation. The RV, GCR release was part of the war to remove the deep state's control that we were a part of as we waited. 12. The deep state threw their Hail Mary pass in the coronavirus pandemic to stop Trump and the white hats, but it was not working. They were losing the war. 13. The coronavirus pandemic was a final delay to starting us that was not in place until after Pelosi's stunts to stop the RV, GCR release failed and after the Mueller Russia hoax investigation failed and after the impeachment failed to stop Trump and the RV, GCR release. 14. The current military operation had to be executed in order to get rid of the current obstacles, booby traps, the deep state put in place to try to stop or delay the RV, GCR. This was why Trump said at the coronavirus press conference yesterday, Monday the 6th of April, "This is a military operation," then VP Pence said it, and as Secretary of Health Admiral Brett Giroir also repeated it, "This is a military operation." 15. Trump also specified at the press conference that the military operation is a fight against drug cartels, and then Trump also specified human trafficking of women and children. 16. Our guy confirmed that human trafficking of women and children among pedophile networks was one of the main sources of funds for the deep state, which had to be cut off in a military operation in order to start us safely. 17. At the daily coronavirus press briefings since last month, Trump has been speaking explicitly about the coronavirus challenge, but has also been making veiled references to winning the war over the deep state and protecting the public and us RV currency holders in redemptions exchanges. 18. Since the end of March, Trump has been alluding to this war against the deep state, creators of the virus. At the Saturday, the 21st of March coronavirus briefing, "We're going to win, and there will be a lot of celebration when we win. And we're going to win with as few lives lost as possible. It's a tough enemy. It's a tough killer, far bigger, far more vicious than ever before. Google whitehouse.gov. One common goal, which is saving American lives. We're going to win with as few lives lost as possible. Tough enemy." 19. The RV, GCR release and our start was part of the war to remove the deep state that was coming to a head during this week's military operations. 20. currency holders would not have had the freedom to spend RRV funds if the White Hats were not removing the deep state control right now. 21. There was a deep state 16-year plan to destroy America, which was started by the Obama two terms and which was to be continued in what the deep state had planned to be a Hillary Clinton two terms, to destroy the infrastructure of the USA. Google's Sun Kyutsu thread: a 16-year plan to destroy America in Kmape.pub 570. The 16-year plan to destroy America. The 16-year plan involved global elites, the Rothschilds, Wall Street bankers, Obama and Hillary Clinton, to crash the American economy and buy it back for pennies on the dollar, so the world would remain under control of the deep state military-industrial globalist complex. 22. The deep state planned that Hillary would follow Obama's actions to put treasonous political operatives at key positions throughout the federal government, just as Obama placed John Brennan, Obama's own handler, over CIA, James Clapper, DNI, Eric Holder and then Loretta Lynch as Attorney General, Valerie Jarrett in White House, James Comey at FBI, etc. 23. As President Hillary Clinton would have continued Obama's actions of shrinking the U.S. military and depleting its resources, while actively funding Iran and North Korea's development of nuclear weapons. The purpose was to start a nuclear World War III that would cause death and destruction on a massive global scale. 24. World War III would have been a fake war promoted by the government-controlled mainstream media. Billions of the world's populations would have died, and the globalists, including Hillary, Obama, Brennan, etc., would have reaped billions of dollars on a global scale. 25. Under the deep state's planned Hillary two terms, the U.S. middle class would have been completely destroyed, the U.S. population be reduced to a status of enslavement, starvation, death, and disease. The U.S. was to have no borders. The Constitution was to be revised to remove the Bill of Rights and all fundamental freedoms, and the population would be disarmed by the repeal of the Second Amendment right to bear arms. Not a pretty picture. 26. This week the 16-year plan and the deep state had to be defeated in military operations that culminated past week's operations in order for us currency holders to have the freedom to use our RV funds to help those in need and heal the planet post-RV. C. April 7, 2020. The Big Call, Bruce, BigCallUniverse.com web link 712-770-4016 pin 123456 hash. 1. On April 1 they announced that stimulus monies were coming in 1-2 weeks, or by Wednesday the 15th of April. Bruce felt that those funds would come out at the same time we set our appointments. 2. Tier 1 group, governments, was supposed to be paid through Dubai 1-2 tiers before the government funds came out. 3. One source said that CMKX package delivery would begin Wednesday the 8th of April. 4. We were in a window to be paid Wednesday the 8th of April through Wednesday the 15th of April. 5. A bank source said 2-3 days after Easter, that would kick it out to Wednesday the 15th of April. 6. Something big was supposed to happen Easter Sunday the 12th of April. 7. Bruce's source said we finished the 3 days of darkness Sunday night the 6th of April. 8. Disclosure would be announced in 8 hours of videos broadcast continually on TV. 9. We should not have to face the internet being down, nor phones going dead. They would be taking down the dark sites. 10. President Trump wanted us to start sometime between now and Good Friday the 10th of April. 11. The Saint Germain Trust should be opened around Easter. D. Monday the 7th of April 2020 morning chat with Markts, www.twitch.tv web link. 1. No news today and I'm not really looking for much to come out until the long Easter weekend. I am hearing this from all my banking contacts and paymasters are looking for something to happen over this Easter weekend, to be in place by Tuesday the 14th of April. 2. My folks working at redemption centers dealing with the exchange logistics also say they won't be ready until then. 3. I'm hearing the delay has honestly been logistics with the CV-19. They don't have the people in place to exchange us. People can't travel. 4. The good thing is they are enforcing the necessity for a reset. We are seeing day-to-day news of the implosion of the fiat currency. 5. Q. Mark, if the Saint Germain Trust opens up on Easter Sunday. How will that affect all of us? Will that benefit us, MZ? Yes, we are being told that the St. Germain Trust will open bright and early on Easter Sunday. It really would be a perfect time to launch this thing, wouldn't it? 6. Member, on the 1st of April they said the stimulus checks were coming in 2 weeks, making it Tuesday the 14th of April. E. April 6, 2020. Everything is at stake, information warfare. And we know, www.youtube.com weblink. F. Coronavirus testing effort hampered by kids contaminated with COVID-19. Bit.ly weblink www.telegraph.co.uk weblink. G. Latest Guard update, more than 21,300 troops mobilized for COVID-19 response, 18 states, 2 territories and DC on Title 32 orders, bit.ly weblink george.news weblink. H. The WikiLeaks list, at least 65 MSM reporters were meeting with and or coordinating offline with top Hillary advisors, bit.ly weblink. I. Worldwide fast on Good Friday the 10th of April. On Sunday the 5th of April, the president of the over 16 million member worldwide Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints called for all peoples of the world to join together in fast and prayer on Good Friday the 10th of April that the global COVID-19 pandemic may be controlled, the economy strengthened, healthcare workers protected and as the prophet Isaiah quoted the Lord, to loose the bands of wickedness, undo heavy burdens and let the oppressed go free. The purpose for this ancient doctrine of fasting and prayer was explained at the 10:30 and 32 seconds mark here, www.youtube.com weblink. J. International Child Sex Trafficking. Q. It's all about the children, saving the children. C. Before D or children before D class. It will be biblical. Let my people go. Thousands of horrifically abused children were being rescued by military personnel from an extensive network of cabal tunnels, presently centering in on New York, Dallas and Los Angeles. Though, military child rescue operations have been ongoing across the U.S. and into Canada and Mexico since at least October 2019. Back in October 2019, around 10,000 Marine Navy SEALs rescued 2,100 children from cages in underground tunnels of the California China Lake military facility, before it is news.com weblink. See a history of cabal Satan worship by kidnapping, rape and torture of children as related to the military's present Central Park rescue mission, Utah.b weblink. Traumatized children, some of whom have never seen the light of day, pregnant preteens, deformed babies, piles of little corpses whose bodies were used for organ harvesting, children locked in cages, electroshocked and traumatized in order to harvest their blood, adrenochrome for the elites to drink, were being carried by Marines out of tunnels beneath New York, Texas and Los Angeles. The sordid stories were hitting the internet, though as yet have not been picked up by our cabal-controlled mainstream media. See this Q Intel video about the tunnels, Utah.b weblink. On Wednesday the 1st of April, a massive assault began under the direction of General Milley. The military, National Guard and Special Operation troops were directed to rescue child victims of trafficking, arrest deep state rats and traffickers, secure threats from deep state internet dark nodes and facial recognition software that was to be used against currency holders post-exchange, 5G microwave abuse against civilians, deliberately contaminated COVID-19 test kits, and other booby traps, all of which were meant to blow up the redemption exchange process. April 1st was said to have begun the 10 days of Dunkus, meaning to save the children, and ended on Good Friday, April 10th. 3 days of Dunkus, meaning to save the children, was said to go between Tuesday to Thursday 7-9 April. The darkness was to cover mass arrests as well as a cover for prosperity package deliveries and Tier 4 bin notifications. A travel permission document would be used by currency holders to travel to redemption centers. Truthhammer Twitter, if tunnels are a minor thing, why have 28 of 31 army brigades trained for subterranean combat? Bit.ly weblink twitter.com weblink www.militarytimes.com weblink. Covert Ops Rescue 10 Days of Dunkus. Cowlapel.wordpress.com weblink. 10 Days of Dunkus, Utah.b weblink. Our POTUS delivers on his very important promise with regard to the executive order he signed combating human trafficking. K. Judy note on currency exchange, Bond redemption, treat the below as my guess. Official instructions would be available upon RV liquidity release. An hour or so prior to liquidity release, Wells Fargo and HSBC banks would send out over 500,000 emails to currency and bondholders, along with instructions on how to exchange and redeem. That information would also be available on certain websites as below. Dinar Chronicles, www.dinarchronicles.com web link. Dinari Recaps, www.dinarrecaps.com web link. Markts, www.twitch.tv web link. Markts Twitter, m.twitter.com web link. Bruce, bigcooluniverse.com web link. TNT Tony, twitter.com web link. Dinar Detectives, dinardetectives.com. U.S. ZIM redemption according to Fleming. The ZIM default rate was $11 million per 100 T-ZIM note. President Trump gave the banks a list of 250 humanitarian and job creation projects for ZIM holders to invest in for higher than default rates on the ZIM. The UST expected 90% of ZIM holders to take the default ZIM rate package and not want to present project ideas for higher ZIM rates, while 10% of ZIM holders would have their wealth manager and team that they would meet with at a second appointment, pursue higher project ZIM rates. It was advised not to be among that 90% that would not pursue the higher ZIM rates. Either present your own project, or invest in some of the 250 sanctioned projects that you would be shown in order to get the highest ZIM rates. Your private banking team that you would meet with at your second appointment would want you to have higher ZIM rates so they could work with more money. If you had less than 1, or up to 9 100 T-ZIM notes, no specific humanitarian project, and if you choose to invest in some of the list of 250 sanctioned international projects, then at your second appointment your wealth manager and private banking team would be more than happy to ask the U.S. Treasury for a higher ZIM rate. If you had 10 or more 100 T-ZIM notes and no specific humanitarian project, then the U.S. Treasury has determined that you would have more than enough and would be among the 90% that would take the default ZIM rate without investing in the sanctioned 250 international humanitarian projects for higher ZIM rates. L. Nonprofits dedicated to help exploited, abused children and adult abuse survivors. Tim Ballard, the Underground Railroad Rescued Exploited Children, ourrescue.org web link. Kevin Annett, International Tribunal into Crimes of Church and State, ITCS, rescued exploited children and exposed their rape, torture and murder kidnapping rings run by the Vatican. Murderbeatgree.com hiddenfromistry1@gmail.com. Felicity Lee, Ivory Garden promoted healing techniques for DID survivors, dissociate identity disorder caused by severe abuse during childhood. Dissociative Identity Disorder PTSD.blogspot.com web link www.igdid.com felicityforus2@gmail.com. Neil Brick, Smart published information on the satanic ritual abuse of children and gave healing seminars for ritual abuse survivors and therapists, ritualabuse.us web link smartnews@aol.com. Enough is Enough. Enough is Enough Registered is a national bipartisan non-profit organization who has led the fight to make the Internet safer for children and families since 1994. EIE's efforts were focused on combating Internet pornography, child pornography, sexual predation, sex trafficking and cyberbullying by incorporating a three-pronged prevention strategy with shared responsibilities between the public, corporate America and the legal community. SNAP, Survivors Network of Those Abused by Priests, www.snapnetwork.org. Caroline Spring, UK, Hope and Healing from Abuse and Dissociation Issues, www.carolinespring.com, info@carolinespring.com. M. 22 Faces, Inside the Extraordinary Life of Jenny Hill and Her 22 Multiple Personalities, Judy Byington. Warning, Jenny gave a graphic description of being raped, tortured and forced to view a child's sacrifice at the tender age of 5, not unlike sordid experiences of thousands of other child victims of satanic worshippers. Such perpetrator followers of Satan were organized from the U.S. incorporated CIA, Queen Elizabeth's, Vatican's Ninth Circle child sacrifice cult on down to the Clintons, Hollywood and Pizzagate and local teenage governs. They appeared funded by this same cabal that ran our global monetary system, The very organization that was in the process of being brought down by activation of the global currency reset. It's no wonder that President Trump has stated, these people are sick. www.youtube.com/link. And Judy note, I do not now, nor have I ever, received monies for writing my updates and articles. The compensation has been in having outlets to help save the children by exposing truths about the very secretive satanic ritual abuse, pedophilia and child sacrifice that was rampant in our international society. To inquire about our international child abuse recovery, trauma survivors, CARTS, humanitarian program, email, info@22faces.com. The above was a summary of information from the internet. It would be up to the reader to do their own research and decide whether or not it was valid. A thank you to those dedicated and brave intel providers who wished to remain unknown, to humble wild fear a lady who was adept at exposing the truth, to Brad who did great research and Ken who uncovered almost unlimited intel on pedophilia to help us save the children. Divide they try, fail they will, where we go one we go all. To support POTUS, follow Q, trust plan. Let us thank Q that the reset has finally come to be. I wish you well in your humanitarian efforts and look forward to seeing you on the other side where together, we will make life better for all.